everyone. I haven't been making videos for a while because well, I just didn't know what to do, and we lost one of our cats a few weeks ago, and it was very sudden, and it was very she became ill on Sunday, and the only thing we noticed that she wouldn't go outside, which wasn't normal for her. So the next day she still didn't want to go outside, and I made an appointment with the vet, and we only could get there in the afternoon, and by the time we were at the vet she was already so sick that we really didn't know what was happening. The vet didn't know, and they took a blood sample, and it turned out her kidneys weren't working anymore. And she was so bad at the time, we noticed what was wrong, that there was really nothing we could do anymore, so she had to put to sleep. And she was only 6 years old, and we really didn't see it coming. We were going through the vet, and we were thinking, well, she might get some antibiotics or something. She didn't really look that ill when we went there and when I made the appointment. And so it was very upsetting to have to say goodbye to her at the vet and not being able to take her home so the kids could say goodbye to her. So it had a bit of impact for me. And I mean, we still have two cats left, but well, it was just very sad, and it took away the the joy of making things and videos. And so I really didn't know what to do for videos, and I have made some shadow boxes, and I will show you them someday, but they're downstairs now, so I don't have them here. And I also did some painting, but it was I really had to drag myself into my craft room and get started. So I thought just to go back to stamping and make something easy. And so I've made this vintage postcard, and I think I will be making more of them because I really like doing this. And I think maybe this is a way to get my mojo back again. I hope so anyway. So I will tell you what I did. You can see in the video, of course, but I will tell you what I used. First, the stamps I used. I went through my stamps and I found some older stamps I have had for a long time, and I really didn't use them anymore that much. For the backside, the postcard, I used this one, and it's from a Belgium stamping company, and it's called Artemio. I don't know if that's correct in English, but anyway, that is the card stamp. And also that's the only one from that brand I used. The Bumblebee is from Indigo Blue. It's number 9 collector's edition, and I really don't know what this brand is because I've had them for so long and I don't have the package anymore. But I used see this one, the border, and these two flourishes, and for the crown I used this one, and this is from Paper World, Viva Decor, it's called, I think. I don't have the package here, but that's also where this set is from, and I used this one for that. The square here is a stamp set I found at the Action. That's some kind of you can compare it to a dollar store. And this one is from, oh, I have not. Let me get it one moment. It's a part of this stamp, and it's called Attic Treasures, and it's by Stampers Anonymous. And they also used, but you hardly can see it here, a part of this stamp. I used distress inks for the background, and I used walnut stain, rusty hinge, vintage photo, tumbled glass, and black suit. The stamping all the images, I used Ranger archival ink in jet black, and I used ground espresso and vintage photo. These are the small ink pads. So that's about it, I think. I hope you like it, and I will come up with some of the other some other vintage cards. And I think I will make the same format, because I really liked it. Oh, I forgot to tell you, the square is a die cut. I bought this secondhand, so I don't have the package anymore. But it's called Vintage Folies. I don't know if I pronounce it right. It's a C6 die, alterations die by Tim Holtz. And it's a vintage suitcase, but I only used this part. And I liked it because the edges are a bit crooked. So I think I will die cut some more from these on white cardstock and make some more cards like this with other images, of course, and I will make some short videos of that. Give you an up close look. The bee is colored with pencils, and it really doesn't matter what kind of pencils you used. I have some Crayola pencils I used. I have just a tin of my go-to pencils that are a cheap brand called Marco Refine, and the Crayola ones. I have a lot of pencils, but these are always on my desk, and the other ones are behind me in my closet. And those are the more expensive pencils that I do use if I have to use color bigger surfaces or make drawings or make something I want to sell. But for a card like this, those pencils work great. So that's about it. I think I told you everything. If anyone knows what the brand of the stamps are, these, please let me know in the comments. And also, if you want to show, if I want to see some other videos, please let me know what kind of videos, because I'm really out of ideas for a while. So I will keep on making some cards, and if you want to see something else, please let me know and I will give it a try. Bye.